Hey everybody, it's Chugga Conroy! Welcome back to more The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword! Last time, we... don't talk about it. We made it through Lynera Desert, that's the important thing. I'm trying to move past the dark times in my life. This time, we are in the Temple of Time. Very redundant once again, starting this off. And we have a bird statue that I want to check first and foremost before anything else. Now, as we get things started, first off, I don't think I've noticed this ledge over here that we can seemingly only reach with our beetle, so I'm going to see what's over there. Now, before you go, ha, this isn't the Temple of Time. They just gave this lame field a dirt a cool sounding name to play in a nostalgia. I see through your tricks. Well, okay, that's what I thought the first time I got to this area, because it does seem a little bit silly that this random patch of desert was given a name like the Temple of Time. But trust me, it does definitely have a purpose. Also, I really need Deku seeds. I don't have it. Well, no. Actually, can a hook beetle activate this? Please tell me that it can. Please, please, please. It replaces the slingshot in many continents. No. Oh, no, it does. Never mind. Okay, so you can do that. It's just a little bit more cumbersome. Thank you for the Deku seeds. I need those. We have loads of time shift stones just everywhere in this place. So let's start off by activating one and just kind of seeing where it gets us, because that seems like a pretty good way to start this off. And okay, this place's cool points are getting risen up just a little bit in my eyes. Oh boy, I don't want to use up a consumable material because I'm running pretty low on those, so just die to my beetle and we'll call it a day. Do that, and then I can't... I suppose maybe I technically could go over there though, but let's not do that. Instead, we'll have our beetle do our collectible grabbing for us, getting us this ancient flower. So we haven't really gotten one of those. Oh, I killed those bugs. I actually flew into them trying to collect them like I would any other material. Yes, so using the beetle to pick up materials does in fact skip the explanation screen if that's the case. Not the net, but the beetle. You over there. Let's try not to kill you. I don't want to knock you off the ledge. You're not dead yet. Hit you with a Skyward Strike, finish you off, boom. For an enemy that gave me so much trouble on my first playthrough and a lot of you guys have been asking me for tips on, I really hope that that's been helpful just in all my tips for fighting that archetype of enemy, because, yeah, it gave me a lot of trouble as well. Not so much anymore. These tactics are actually quite good for fighting them. I'm gonna keep my promise by spinning in circles inside of this. And, oh boy. Now I'll get a chance to go over there on my own. There's a minecart over that way. So, this place is semi-cool. We do have a bit more of the time travel mechanic that we didn't really see a whole lot of in the desert itself, but we saw a lot in the mine, so it's making a comeback. But... prepare to be won over. Is the coolest thing ever, and it made me fall in love with this area all over again, and it actually does kind of make sense for it to be called the Temple of Time if it does have all this time travel stuff all over it, so I'll at least give it points for that much. Killed you in a very cool way. I thought I was headed straight for death when I active. No, stop, don't, take me back there now. Okay, whatever. Finally. Link, I didn't tell you to get out. You did that on your own while I was commanding the beetle, and it took control of the beetle away from me as well. You don't need to get out just because the minecart has stopped. Let me hit this. And that'll open that. Me going through there in one go was almost cool, and then that happened. So we'll do that. And as if this area could not remind you any more of Okami, just... it's so pretty. It really is. It's just so, so nice. I love it. Go ahead, get out right here, grab myself another ancient flower, and I guess just to prove the fact that, yeah, I hadn't already collected one in this session, I got the explanation screen that time. I've had some people telling me that I'm being too harsh on the explanations because you can technically bypass them, but my response to that is I shouldn't need a strategy to not have an item explained to me for the 30th time when I already have known what it does since the very beginning of this quest. I really shouldn't have to do that. On top of that, people have been telling me that I shouldn't be counting treasure chests, though, because of course treasure chests are going to give you explanations, but my argument is not so much that... it's not so much that, well, you know, of course treasure chests are going to do that for you. It's that it's explaining it to me again in the first place. My argument is not that you know, it's avoidable. My argument is that it's explaining something to me over again, so that's my reasoning for that. Also, we haven't fought Octorox in a while. It's kind of nice to fight such an easy enemy after everything that we've dealt with. Not naming any names, I'm just saying that we may or may not have fought some enemies that I was not a very big fan of, and that I considered to be individuals whose parents were never married, which was a very G-rated way of saying what I think of them. Thank you. And we already got full up on bombs. Good. Now, over this way, we've got another one of those cicadas. These are not a terribly common bug. I don't remember if they're necessary for a whole lot, though, but I guess just in case Stritch is willing to buy them, I might as well catch it when I see it. Hop over, just galloping. And now, check out who it is.
Good to see you, bud. Seems like you pop up everywhere, though I'm one to talk. Anyway, bud, there's something I'm dying to tell you. It's the discovery of the century. This sacred place is known as the Temple of Time.
Ah, so you got the pop-up message in the corner of your vision too, huh?
I could not believe my eyes when I saw a human who lives on the legendary Isle of the Goddess.
Well, bud, I don't mean to brag, but
it wore clothes just like the ones written about in ancient manuscripts, and it looked just like you, but...
Oh. Man, and here I thought I was going to be the center of this legend, but no, I guess now we know why the title is the way it is.
It came with another person, and they entered the temple. I wanted to chase after him, but there was an explosion all of a sudden in the entrance. Well, you can see for yourself, bud. I do not think we're getting past this mess. I just wish we could find out what is happening on the other side.
You have enormous biceps, and you're made of rock. If nothing else, you could just sit on this, and it would probably go away, but okay, fine, sure. Yeah, we're not getting through there. There has been yet another brick wall erected between us and Zelda. Can't use a bomb or anything like that to destroy the... He reacted to me throwing a bomb. Does that mean... Oh, wow! He actually rolls up into a ball like in Majora's Mask! Oh! That's kind of cool, actually. I didn't know he was gonna do that. That's... Cool new discovery, wow. Always learning new little details about this. That's the thing, I've had a lot of people telling me that they didn't know just how detailed and in-depth Skyward Sword was until they saw me play it, which, first off, that's incredibly flattering to hear, though, but I gotta be honest, I knew that I wanted to do this game for a while, but it wasn't until I went back to just kind of, like, play through it again to kind of get refreshed on things a few months ago that I realized that myself. It was so much more in-depth than I remembered. There were so many ways to fight enemies, and it led to the combat being so interesting, there being so many ways to solve puzzles, and it's an open-endedness that I enjoy. Yes, Skyward Sword is a bit on the linear side, and yeah, it doesn't have as much exploration, but you see... The open-endedness comes in just the number of ways that you can accomplish a given task. Every playthrough feels different, and that's why I think it is so worth replaying, even though there are people that haven't done it by this point. Even though it might not have seemed like it at first, and like it wasn't really all that big, and that there wasn't really a whole lot of new stuff that you could do on repeat. When a cutscene costs you a kill. Thank you.
Help, Zert!
I was getting to the helping, just saying. Fine, whatever. You can do that, sure. You can't reach me outside of here. I can attack you from a safe distance, and then I can finish you off. Thank you. And before that guy was gonna drop a golden skull. But yeah, it's one of those games where there's so many ways that you can accomplish a given task that I think that's what makes it so worth replaying and why I think it's so good and replayable. Now, what are you gonna say, actually?
That was scary. Vroom. Thanks for helping me. Bzzzt. This is the Temple of Time. Within it is the Sacred Gate of Time, made by the goddess. Bzzzt. It is my job to patrol the outside of the temple. Vroom. If you want to reach the Gate of Time, you will need to pass through that door. Zap.
So he turns into a colorless energy after you knock him out that can be attached to the next Pokemon that you send out. Okay, sorry, I had to do that. Yeah, we need another way in. The Lunera Mining Facility and the Temple of Time are connected underground. Bzzzt. The Lunera Mining Facility is right here. Oh, I thought you meant, like, literally right here. That's usually what that means. This map, it looks inaccurate. Bzzzt, I'm going to fix it for you, Zerm.
So now we have a map of what this area looked like in the past, revealing to us where structures may actually be laying underground.
Lunera Mining Facility is just ahead. Good luck, Vert. Hey, I told you, no verting in public. Oh boy.
A report, Master Link. The map you possessed corresponds to the actual terrain of this area with only 35% accuracy. The robot you met earlier modified your map to show you past terrain that is now submerged below the sink sand. Okay, okay. You haven't been that bad lately, actually. You've been okay. You've been all right, Fi. You've been. I wouldn't say cool, but you know, not as bad as you were there for a while. You did kind of cool down a little bit. Yeah, I did calm down. I guess maybe you were a little bit sleep deprived from just how often you were 24/7 re-explaining things to us, though. So you're kind of catching up on your beauty rest right now and just kind of recuperating from your sleep debt. I understand how all that is. I oftentimes have sleep debts that I need to recover from. Get another ancient flower right here. Just, again, swimming in the collectibles. And now, this is one of my favorite things. You get into this, and as much as I want to spin around in circles, that'll have to wait for a few seconds, because do a Skyward Strike as you pass by, charging as you're going up the up ramp, and get a very clever goddess cube unlocked from it. That's awesome. Now, gotta get in my daily recommended allowance of spinning. Oh my god, spinning with the sword help being held out in front of you looks even funnier. That's great. These guys... I was trying to correct calling the cactuses guys, but I just corrected the pronoun that I used in front of them. Hit the flower! Beetle, you're the only one I can trust in this world. Hit it for me, thank you. And did that not actually give me any Deku seeds? No, it did not. I need Deku seeds. Nope, come on. I want to hit it with my sword. I haven't really been doing that. Come on. Oh, I guess I just deflect it. I know that there are ways that you can hit them with it. I've done it before, though, but I guess I use the shield bash for a reason. Hit me. Thank you. If I can please get some Deku seeds, that would be very lovely right about now. I've been a little bit too trigger happy with my slingshot. Nothing. Okay. Well, this is roughly the way that we came in. We did not hit this time stone on the way in, however. So how about we do that now and access an area that was previously inaccessible to us? I'm not even upset that we can't view this entire area all, like, glowy and green at the same time. It's so creative the way that they do things. Hi! Get out, get out. Oh, whoa. I barely managed to do that. Oh, he's not dead. No, okay, whatever. I slashed a dragonfly in two before killing you. I'm sorry. I know it's kind of gruesome, though, but just slashing bugs in half like that with your sword, it's something I'm kind of glad they put in the game, even if it does kind of cost you collectibles from time to time, because it is kind of funny just how a random bug is just kind of flying by while you're trying to kill stuff, and it gets caught in the crossfire and slashed in two. But out we go here. We did hear that the Lanayru mining facility in the middle of the Lanayru Desert was roughly around here. Should we check our map? We can see submerged pathways beneath the sand. I'm going to put a beacon on the pathway so that I know that I can run over to that area safely. These are always going to be in straight lines if they're extending out from the middle. So by doing this, you know the safe areas. There I was able to do it just fine. Master Link, I have information to report. I can confirm that you will not be consumed by the sink sand in this current position. I suggest verifying your location on the map. Readings indicate that there is a submerged path beneath the sink sand. It is possible to walk along a route beyond this path without submerging completely into the sink sand. Simulation suggests that placing beacons in the... Fi, I was not one step ahead of you. I was, like, four steps ahead of you in this case. Oh! I shouldn't get too terribly mad. She gave us five beacons now instead of just one. That's actually going to be very instrumental to getting through this area because you can place it on the corners knowing where you're supposed to turn. So we'll take this, get a dragonfly to make up for the one that I so violently mutilated, and we'll get that now. Also, wherever you see grass growing, that indicates that there is ground very close beneath the surface, so that's another tip that you can use in order to get through these areas really simple. It's not all that complicated once you know to look at the map and all that things. Again, it is yet another use for the map that is a lot more helpful than it has been in the past. You can see that guy's got a rock in his mouth. What? I actually don't know the names of these guys because they're so often just out of your reach that I can never lock onto them. I need to give you a name. Rockakin, Pelorock, Parabolder, Boulderkin. I'll think of something over time. I just seem to want to name all the birds, not just my own at this point. So we'll go up this way. Can I lock onto you from here? No, you're still too far away. Oh well. Thought it would be kind of fun, but I suppose not. I guess Fi had other ideas. And I guess on that note, I've had some people telling me that they don't agree with my pronunciation of Fi, just kind of saying that they've always said it Fee or, you know, Fi or Foe or Fum. Okay, no. Maybe not those last two, though, but still. I do hear a lot of differing pronunciations on them. Some people say Fei even because of the Japanese spelling, though, but the Japanese spelling is what you see on screen right now. Phonetically, that can only be pronounced as Fi. In Japanese, vowels don't change depending on context, and as far as I'm concerned, I'm about as accurate as can be with that pronunciation, and I think it's pretty clear that when it was being translated, it was intended as Fi, and wow, that is the most... Oh, it actually still worked. I was about to say, that is like... Oh, I blew up the wall. Okay, fine. I was going to say that that is quite possibly the worst of all advanced basketball techniques to ever pull off, but wow, that was kind of funny, especially after all my talk of basketball earlier. But yeah, I think that is about as close to the Japanese pronunciation as can be. I think it's pretty clear that that was intended. You obviously can say it however you want. That's just how I'm personally going to be doing it, so I don't really want to change that. You look kind of suspicious, Verm. Don't let me catch you fiddling with this device. Bzzzt. By fiddling, you mean stabbing. You can turn it along the arrow, push it in. We've now activated some kind of switch that activates another switch in the middle of the area. Roundabout way of saying it yet again. Gonna grab that, get an Amber Relic for our troubles. And nothing over here. Okay, just thought I'd make sure. And I guess I'll meet you guys back over in the middle. That blissful oasis of Island Paradise. Oh! Oh, you can actually see the path continuing out of the sand. That is a nice touch. I didn't notice that before. Wow. Just noticing so many things I didn't know the first time around kind of questions how observant I actually am about things. Over this way, I'm not low on health, but maybe you are, and you would appreciate this random out-of-place stool. I'll be sure to pass on your kind commas to the interior decorators of this desert. Or exterior decorators? Anytime you want to blow up, thank you! We uncover a time-shift stone that once again should have totally been activated by that bomb, and looks like we got some things we gotta deal with. Just making sure once again, can never be too careful with those sorts of things. We'll activate this and see that we have more Techno Blends to deal with. So with this active, we can do roughly the same thing that we were doing before. We can see that on the map, this is over here in the circle. We can stab this, move that into position, and push it into place. You can see that that will activate something. However, we do not have all three of those rings active, so we aren't able to do them all. At least not yet, we aren't. Oh, I hit both of them! Oh, wow! I wasn't able to finish both of them, though, but still, that was a very good fight, except for the fact that I totally... What is it with me swatting them outside of the... I don't usually have problems with that. That's usually not really a concern of mine that I'm going to hit them around too much and knock them out, but maybe I... Wow, I'm better at basketball than I ever realized. That takes some serious skill to get it stuck in the between the backboard and the hoop. I almost called it the net. I guess I'm not really too up to date on that terminology, though, but hey. I don't feel like I even use that many bombs, yet I always have to replenish like 10 of them every time I get to a spot where you can obtain bomb flowers. It's kind of incredible. Got multiple things that we can blow up here. Those subtle little cracks that we saw in the Earth Temple aren't exactly so subtle anymore now that the lighting and background has changed. You think they would have introduced it the other way around, though, but hey, I'm kind of okay with this, with my favorite of these three regions being the third one. That looks cool how those chunks of rock were still up there. And that opens up a nice little doorway for 999 rupees. It looks like I'm maxed out, but no, I'm not. And I ran into an invisible wall as I was going in there. Yes, we have a bit of an interior factory-looking place. You remember this is a mining operation and it makes a lot of sense. Here we have barrels. They can have a lot of different items in them. Like there, they have Deku seeds. I think right there, yeah, we got a stack of bombs. Our first time ever picking up one of these. So 2 is 5 and 3 is 10, I suppose, based on how the models have been. Definitely make it a point to break any barrels that you see, because they can have great stuff in them that you don't always find, and it'll save you having to support Rupin's business model.
I think I will just bust open all these barrels, completely throwing caution to the wind, because whatever corporation owned this factory went out of business like 2,000 years ago when the world ended. Their capital is my capital. Let's be real here. Wow. I got outsmarted by an enemy that was too stupid to even notice a bomb going off in front of it. Even, like, Goron seemed to be able to notice that, and he didn't. I suddenly feel a lot less good about myself. You... I'm starting to think maybe I'll just kind of ignore these guys and hope for the best. Maybe that they won't hit me. If they do come near me, I'll just shield bash them. I think that's going to be the way to go. I'll run over here. Barely make it. Drop you down. I'll dig in the meantime. I'm being efficient with my time management. Didn't get anything of help there. Oh. I think he was noticing me, though, but then... Oop! Nope, not today. Boom, 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 boom. Thank you. For once, one of you that happened to live in a quicksand-inhabited area was not a pain to kill. I thought he was going to come after me in the cutscene again right there. Oh! Yes! We made the Ampelus go back in time and reduced them to being just mere eggs of their former selves. This is a new enemy that we have ahead of us. Ampelus eggs. I want to see if I can actually... No, I guess Fi doesn't really have a bio for them. Okay, cool. Should you slash them with your sword or try to pick them up or anything like that, they will electrify you. You can throw them, you can roll them, you can get them through the room in that way. But what you want to do more than all is that your beetle is capable of picking them up now that it has that hook on it. You drop them onto these. And once you stand on this, that'll open that way. And once they're already here, Fi will let you know exactly what you have to do. Oh, she's just telling us that it's operable. Okay, cool. Not nearly as bad as I thought. See, you gotta give her credit. And that'll open the way to the back room. I do think I want to just run back here and raid whatever treasure that I can find, because there's quite a lot of it that was beneath that sand. First off, a blue rupee. Hooray. I just realized the Technoblins are wearing clown pants. That is so cute. I just thought they had futuristic outfits because Fi is like they have the latest in Bokoblin technology. Oh my god, he's like, you can't get off my lawn! That is a phase only a mother can love, and the goggles make it even better. Oh my god. Man, the clown... When she was saying that they have, like, the latest in fashion, I was thinking, oh, she's making fun of how silly futuristic outfits typically look in fiction, but no, they're actually wearing clown pants. That's kind of incredible, wow. As you're going through here, you might find areas that you seemingly can't reach. This is where things get clever. Uh-oh. I'm standing on flooring. Okay, that's good. What you want to do... is get over to where that is. Nope, not today. Not today. Please die, good sir. I'm hitting you with the very tip of my sword. You'd think that I'm Marth. And I think we saw that it was over here. Yeah, okay. I can safely stand on this. Safely stand on this. I guess that's also somewhat applicable. And you want to hit that time shift stone in the center from over a great distance. That'll return it to the past. And you can be wherever it is you want to be to get your items. Unless they fall off the cliff, which thankfully they did not. Can't reach that. So you have to do the incredibly cool thing of using time travel to platform. We got one final digging spot that has more useless hearts that I don't need. I'm surprised at just how much health that I've had at all times. Usually I do need potions a lot more than I have. Got a second one of these machines. Turn it, push it in. And we found the place of the lightning symbol. All that's left is the one that's stuck in the middle, and I wonder what it ever could be. Now, this is just a simple basic room. There's just this one little altar at the end of it, and then you'd probably just leave without really doing anything else. There's no items for you to get. The map doesn't even show any chests. But I want to showcase this. Look up. Just, wow! You have this happy sun, and it's so glowy, and the lighting is pretty, and this whole stained glass look to it. You probably wouldn't ever know that this is here if you, like, weren't, like, I guess, okay, maybe you don't need to pay that close attention, though. But still, it's an awful lot of detail to put into a room that is just used one time to throw a switch, has nothing else really all that interesting about it, and you could very easily just walk past it without even noticing. I would say that I feel bad for the texture artist that had to draw that, but I still got paid. You know, I'm gonna interrupt things right here for a second to say that this is going on a lot longer than I thought it would. We have finished the Temple of Time, and we've thrown two of the switches. We do have the one left, as well as the rest of this desert area. But I think we're actually gonna end things off here. Next time on The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword, we go after that third and final switch, and make our preparations for the Lanayru Mining Facility. See you guys then.